If you like this video, please click like button down below.
Welcome to a new Blender tutorial. So a YouTuber asked me how to make fighting animations. So we are going to do that. I have two characters here. This second one is just a cloned version of the first one. And I used Autoric Pro to rig this model. It's from Dust3D. Free animation software. So let us get started. We need to have the character in a default pose or a pose that you want to start with. Select all of the bones and pick eye and then look root scale. Then we are going to go to let us go to frame 10, and let us then just take the foot about here. Now we are going to go here, rotate this, like so, 40 degrees, select the foot animation. No, what did I say? Select the foot and drag it a little bit to the side. Take this take the arm and drag it a little bit forward. This one too. Drag this backwards a little bit. Yes, this little shape that you can see on the elbow. Now, on frame 20, select this bone again, or the bone you need can be the hips. I'll rotate it this way and drag this over here. Take this one and just drag it backwards. It doesn't matter how much. This one forward. We rotated it even more. Let us see. Try to make it so it doesn't look like you broke the leg. Yes, let us take character number 2. Let's watch this animation. Let us take and fix some animations. Okay, that looks good. The last thing is that you're going to go from here and then go here and rotate this a little. So what happens now is that it looks like you get some speed. So yeah. And this one should go even more back. Okay. So now we have the first animation. You don't even need to reset this one. So we are going to, yes, when you open this, you will see the F curve editor. So just select all of the bones in this one. If you want to reset them, select this keys here, click Shift D and then click X. And then move them to about frame 30. I did miss it. Let us drag them frame 40. Okay. Now let us take this frame here and move them. Maybe goes a little too fast. Let us just try to fix that. There we go. Okay, that should be it. So let us see now. This is something I don't like. And that is here, like how the leg is actually. I need to try to get it rotated. Here we saw something, so I need to drag this up a bit to the sides. There we go. If you want this faster or slower, you know, you can just do that. So this would be the first animation. Let's go back to the video editor and change this from graph editor to Adobe Sheet. Next animation. Okay, let us now go back to here. And of course, something can't just work. Oh, and of course, it can't work. So I also try to get this back again. Wait a second. Okay, let us now continue. Now for punch animation. The first thing we have to do is that we have to get the hand to the right position. Come on! I will lift this up. And rotate it. Then I will select this one, and I will change this from global to normal. And start to rotate this. It looks like this new headset that I just bought is broke. This don't looks really good, but it doesn't really matter. You know, you can make it much better if you just take your time. Just rotate this one to about here, I believe. Come on. Okay, let us try to continue. Get this to around here. Okay, let us now take this one and drag it a little bit in here. This one, and this one. I now see that I did something very stupid. You maybe see that too. I did it on frame 0. The good thing is that I still hold the action. I still have the kick action, so I can just do this. It should work. Please work. Let us now try to continue.
Are you kidding with me? What is going on?
Look at scale. Okay. Blender. Go in here, control V.
Are you kidding with me? Why can't you just work? I mean, is that... This is something that always happens. Blender can do the work sometimes.
Let's hope that it works. If not, I have to actually be a little more creative.
What is going on? What animation did I just select?
Let's try again. This was not something that just happened. I don't think that this was random. Something definitely happened here. Since I just need to do this again, I will just do that really fast. I will just speed this up, so... Okay, and now we have the fist here. This don't look very good, but you know, it's a really fast animation, so. So I take this and take it back roll. Take this hand here. Something like this. Take this back to global so I don't do anything wrong. So we are going to take it here, rotate it a little bit. Then here. Rotate this bone here, this way, drag this back, drag it backward, and take this and drag it to about here, like this, and then I have to select this one to get the elbow, then I will take this here, I just let us do it. And then, let's see how this looks. Let us take it down. Here we have a bag. The arm shouldn't be like this, so now it has to be something like this. Turn off, there's nothing. I can control this. Don't looks good. I believe I have to rotate it a little bit more like this. There we go, that looks more like a that they're punching someone or something. So what happens is that you take body, rotate it backwards, keep this hand forward, to just try to hold the other one a little bit apart, and then you just do something doing like this. Again. There we go. Take this little bit more backwards. There we go. need to move this frames a little bit closer. Let us see if this... Okay, next is... This. This don't look good. So, this one here is okay. I take this away too. There we go. Then when we set this up. That was animation number 2. We need one more. Let us go back to Adobe Key. And then let us just click on the plus icon and type in fight 3. And this one. Okay, so I want to keep this animation, I want to keep this one here. Going to be a little bit different. What is going on? Something is wrong here. There we go, let us see if I now can do this. There we go. Then, on frame number 10, I will again select this bone here. But I will also select this bone here on the frame number 10 and let's make some ninja, maybe ninja style, maybe. Again, this is an AK rig, so it's almost perfect. Yeah, I'm almost done. There we go. There we go. And then on frame 30. Going to just take this wait, I should have done that this frame. Okay, so I didn't animate that one. Clearly I did not animate that one. Oh, the program did just crash. Okay, now it should work. Let us change this from global to normal. Let's take this handle now and just rotate it a little bit. Drag it. Rotate it up. Okay, let us now finish this here. Select this two here and drag this. Let us drag it even closer. Maybe a little bit too close. So this will be the tutorial. The last thing I will show you now is how to get this out. So in order to export this properly, if you want to use this in a game engine, select all of them. Make sure that you have the rig selected. Go to File, Export, FBX. Shift select this too, click select did object, go in here, turn off this one, and that should be it. And then you just click on export. I will not do that now because this character here have so many shape keys, like I believe it's over 100. And then you have this one that have more, so yeah. I'm not going to do that, but you can do it, so. So, if you did like this video, please click like button down below. If you learned something, please click like button down below. And if you do, please click the subscribe button and don't forget to click the bell notification so you don't miss out whenever I upload a new video. If you didn't like the video, I believe that you click dislike. And I hope I see you in the next episode. So, goodbye.